morning, ladies and gentlemen. The ceremony will begin shortly, so please could you bear the following points in mind. In the event of an emergency, the ceremony ushers will instruct you on what to do and will guide you from the hall if necessary. Can I ask you to keep the aisles clear when the students are invited onto the stage? Can you please check that you have turned off your mobile phones? The ceremony will be recorded, and in the event that you have to leave the hall and feel unable to return, the ceremony will be shown live in the bar area. And finally, please be aware that there will be flash photography throughout the ceremony. And now, can I please ask you to stand for the arrival of the platform party?
Good morning and welcome to this graduation ceremony. As Pro-Rector Learning and Teaching, I will be introducing the speakers and the different stages of the ceremony. Please remain standing whilst the proclamation is read out. This will firstly be in Cornish.
Rebog of Vevers Le Ciliol and College Universita, Dresvu, Contellians College Universita Falmouth. Genitorta Rove Governs College Universita Falmouth and Contellians Mavis Gras, Malborsum Mutias Cubis of Viscablum. Of the examiners, Hikevis Worthy, the Gawaska degrees, De Virtue Gustavians are Werler Les and College Universita. Waller Torata Rough Governs and College Universita, Avi Complis Kens, Frima Tarivas, Drew Egger, and Guntellians, Ragrontians Poajo Descus, Cafrias Poajo Ro, Agrontians Cascoafians Avri, Foronaiacolia Suenians Arima, Ezakoas Degrees, and Guntellians Ma, Adriver Gavaho, and Charge the Gavrada. Sparus and College Universita. For Ratnan G, for Willis and Les Kabum, for Willis are Puefen Dwell and Pubtra, her Camaras we for Gumbez. Let it be known to all members of the University College that today in Falmouth, Cornwall, Congregation of University College Falmouth is taking place. Under the authority of the University College's Articles of Government, this congregation meets to receive those students who, by virtue of their studies, have been appropriately examined according to the statutes of the University College and found worthy of their degrees. By the authority of the aforementioned University College's Articles of Government, I declare that this congregation open for the conferment of academic and other awards and the award of honorary fellowship. We celebrate the success of those who graduate in this congregation and in doing so remind them of their responsibility to share in the values of the University College. It is for them to seek for their achievements, to serve the common good, to strive for excellence in all things and care for the future of our world.
Please be seated. I would now like to invite Howard Jacobs, Deputy Chairman of the Board of Governors, to open the proceedings.
As Deputy Chairman of the Board of Governors, it is my very great pleasure to welcome you all, honoured guests, graduates, parents, partners, friends and family, to today's University College Falmouth graduation ceremony. More formally, today, under the powers granted to University College Falmouth to award university degrees and honorary awards, we confer degrees on you, the graduands, in recognition of your achievement in completing your chosen course of study here at Falmouth. We shall also be conferring an honorary fellowship on Dr. Tom Hunter, to acknowledge his contribution to the work of the University College. At Falmouth, we are justifiably proud of the achievements of our students, many of whom have already distinguished themselves in international competitions, and all of us are delighted to see them come up to collect their awards. But speaking as a parent, their success is more of a joint effort than is often appreciated, which is why it is so very good to see you parents, families and friends of the successful graduates here as well. And even if your visit is brief, I hope that you get a sense at first hand of the unique Cornish cultural environment here in Falmouth, so influential in the development of the creative talent that we recognise at today's ceremony. We can't wish the economic gloom away, and it will take more time yet for growth to recover from the shocks of recent years. But today's graduates are now qualified in a discipline which feeds the creative industries of this country and beyond. The new world economic order, to which our country, like others, rapidly has to adapt, places a premium on those with superior creative skills. At Falmouth, it remains our determination to ensure that all of our graduates will be in that top draw. The college itself continues to grow and also to change. We are proud of the distance we have travelled, what we have achieved, and are continuing to achieve, guided by a vision which is broad and embracing. As a Board of Governors, we have to be sure that Falmouth continues to respond to the dramatic changes in the world of higher education, a world where perpetual revolution seems to be the new normal. We have to remain confident in our abilities to be fit for purpose in a world where, as we are already starting to see, higher tuition fees are creating new competitive stresses. And we must be unwavering in our ambition to be one of the world's leaders in arts education, whatever the short-term pressures. Today, graduates may mark the end of your formal education here, but not the link that binds you to University College Falmouth. We have great faith in you, and we want to know of your successes. Thank you.
I would like to invite the first group of graduands to the stage and Julian Rodriguez, Head of Department of Media, to announce the names of the graduands.
Rector, I have the honour to present the following graduands who have satisfied the requirements to be awarded a Bachelor of Arts degree with honours in Marine and Natural History Photography. Hannah Aitkinson. Natasha Bly. Darren Burgess. Sophia Castillo. Daniel Chapman. Rebecca Cleland. Ian Cubbon. Katie Davidson. Holly DeRoy. Samuel Fogg. Mark Fox. Letty Irving. Joshua Jaggard. Sarah Jones. James Lewis. Andrew Mellors. Kevin Murphy. Jack Perks. Hannah Pickard. Jackie Poon. James Porter. Ben Potherow. Thank you. George Rogers. Melissa Salafiel. Kelly Marie Smith. Sam Stewart. Grace Street. Ruby Wood. Rector, I have the honour to present the following graduands who have satisfied the requirements to be awarded a Bachelor of Arts degree with honours in photography. Amy Baxendale. Hannah Beck. Ryan Bleswick. Araminta Bond. Laura Brown. Stephen Burke. Lucy Burlock. Samantha Clinch. Sarah Coxon. Hayley Dowling. Charlotte Down. Joshua XL. James Fish. Emily Fitch. Sarah Francis. Kim Glazier. Lisa Grigsby. Henrik Hildre. Faye Hobson. Congratulations. Damien Hockey. Claire Holmes. Harriet Ibbotson. Richard Johnston. Abigail Corrales. Jake Kenny. Elaine Cosmo. Daniel Landsberg. It's okay. Molly Landsman. Jonathan Lewis. Sophie Lund. Claire Macklin. Grace Martinez. Alexandra Mason. Rachel Moffat. Emilia Moisio. Jessica Morris. Chester Monsha. Danielle Navarette. Alistair Nicol. Tomasz Ogradinski. Samuel Orchard. Lucy Palmer. Brittany Pay. Mark Perham. Woo! Andrew Price. Jessica Rees. Samantha Reed. Hannah Rochford. Lena Rogers. Gareth Rudge. Jack Scott. Toma Sheltiel. Joanna Shuka. Natalie Skulski. Emma Swaby. Michael Swan. Melissa Tullett. Hannah Vallis. Laurie Watkins. Harriet Webb. Emma Welton. Christopher Wilkins. Laura Wilkinson. Samantha Wilson. Gregory Woodward. Rector, I have the honour to present the following graduands who have satisfied the requirements to be awarded a Bachelor of Arts degree with honours in press and editorial photography. James Allen. Daniel Barnes. Woo! Elliot Barnes. Jack Bennett. Emily Britton. Daniel Caney. Thomas Carpenter. Tessa Carroll. How you doing? Charlotte Clancy. Emily Cole. Stephen Coombs. Well done, Simon. Simon David. Catherine Durham. Michael Etherington. Amber Higgs Horson. Christopher Hoare. Mohammed Hussein. Thomas Jameson. Marcantonio Kessler. Rebecca Lazar. Georgina Mallett. Joshua Matthewman. Anna Nielsen. Juan Rodriguez Delgado. Jonathan Ross Elliott. Elizabeth Saunders. Steph Simpson. Eleanor Spanswick. Liam Stackpole. Edward Stone. Gregory Stachy. Peter Wright. Rector, I would also like us to celebrate those graduands who have today received their degrees in absentia.
I now invite Professor Jeff Smith, Deputy Rector, to announce the prizes.
The Ferdinand Zweig Memorial Scholarship was created to enable Falmouth students to explore the artistic and cultural achievements of other nations. Scholarships are used to support travel and study with both a practical and theoretical purpose. Rector, I have the honour to present the following student, who is one of this year's recipients of the Ferdinand Zweig Memorial Scholarship and about to leave for Northern Greece to produce a photographic project. Matthew Oxley. Falmouth would like to thank all of its student mentors for the enormous amounts of enthusiasm, time, and effort you have given in your role as student mentors. You should be proud to know that many new students were so much happier coming to University College Falmouth and embarking on a new chapter in their lives because of the huge efforts you made to make them feel welcome and part of something even before they arrived. Through your mentoring role, you have made a real difference to many of your mentees' first year here at Falmouth, providing support and friendship and helping to make it the best experience it could possibly be. Here's a typical comment. My mentor has been exceptional in their role, and without him, I probably wouldn't even be here at Falmouth. He has done his utmost in providing the professional manner of a mentor and an exceptional friend. We would therefore like to extend a heartfelt thank you to all from the university and the mentor coordinating team have had the privilege to work with such committed, enthusiastic mentors. If I can ask the student mentors to stand, and for all of us to give them a well-deserved round of applause, please.
I now invite Professor Anne Carlisle, Rector and Chief Executive, to address the Assembly.
Chair, honoured guests, ladies and gentlemen, graduates.
This, of course, is a day of great pride and celebration in the life of University College Falmouth, in the life of the graduates in front of me, and in the life of their family and friends. Now, I always feel honoured and quite a bit humbled on these occasions, because these events are, of course, rites of passage. They mark the end of one journey and the start of another, the transition from student learning to lifelong learning. They mark the moment our graduates of 2012 embark on their first solo flight towards what I'm sure will be absolutely brilliant careers. Now, for the majority of you, this journey started 3 years ago, but whether it was more years or less years, today all of you finally stop being students and become graduates. Perhaps most importantly, you join an extremely exclusive club, which is Falmouth Alumni, and of course you become our greatest ambassadors. I very much hope that you are proud to be a graduate of Falmouth and to have studied in this inspirational place that has been for so long associated with creative and cultural innovation and is now home to the second largest creative industries cluster in the United Kingdom. Now, the span of over 110 years since the first students graduated from Falmouth has seen an institution transformed. This university college, which stands so confidently at the brink of its next stage of development, when we will become known as Falmouth University, is one that our first graduating students all those years ago could not possibly have dreamt of. A growing and prosperous Falmouth that is accomplished, dynamic, innovative, proud of all its people, its creativity, its heritage. A Falmouth at the heart of both the cultural and creative industries, respected for the quality of its graduates regionally, nationally, and across the world. Originally founded as Falmouth Art School in 1902, Falmouth has over its history grown from a small art school of less than 200 students to, by 2012, a multi-arts university with over 3,500 full-time students studying art, design, media, performance and writing. While we are one university, we are situated across two great campuses, in Falmouth and in Penryn. The historic Wood Lane campus is now home to fine art, graphics, illustration, fashion and performance sportswear. And in 1998, Falmouth acquired a large site at Tremoe at Penryn, which we have developed over 10 years with over £100 million worth of investment to produce an exemplary campus with state-of-the-art facilities for photography, media and design. And today, two-thirds of all Falmouth students are now housed there. An important landmark and chapter in our history was a consequence of our merger with Dartington College of Arts in 2008, when they relocated to our £60 million purpose-built performance centre in Penryn in October 2010. This enabled Falmouth to assume a special place in the UK higher education landscape, as we uniquely, of all institutions, offer all the art forms in equal measure. Now, the past 10 years have been extraordinary for Falmouth. The scale of what has already been accomplished in such a short time allows us to embrace our future with well-based confidence and hope. Now, on special days like today, it is worth asking what makes Falmouth special and what makes our graduates special. First, I'd like to say it's not only what we do, but it's how we, or should I say you, do it. We are a community of scholars, first and foremost, but we're also a concentrated group of innovative thinkers, makers, and doers. Our educational philosophy is built upon the Falmouth tradition of making sure our students acquire high-level skills while encouraging them to think laterally, be imaginative, be experimental, and operate professionally across a range of disciplines. As a result, we produce highly employable and professionally clever graduates with the expertise to be successful in both the growing cultural and creative industries, as well as the flexibility and imagination to apply their creativity for the benefit of many other sectors. We're also proud of our research and the innovation that is growing out of our Academy for Innovation and Research. We take pride in our interdisciplinary outlook and also the way in which we're able to work across sectors such as environment, energy and health, amongst others. I'm also very proud that we're not an educational ivory tower, and we're highly committed to growing Cornwall, and we regard Cornwall's success as intrinsically linked to our own. We're working with outside agencies as I speak to grow on space, to create studios and facilities to allow many more of our graduates to stay here and to successfully set up creative enterprises and businesses. Our future plans include developing even stronger links with the two towns around us, both Falmouth and Penryn. And at the minute, we are developing new facilities and centres of excellence at both Wood Lane and Falmouth, and also continuing to grow in Tremoe. Our outlook, of course, is necessarily international, and our portfolio is increasingly internationalised. We believe this diversification immeasurably enriches the student experience and will improve the social mobility of our students and graduates and making them highly effective in the global employment market. Now, of course, graduates, we cannot at Falmouth claim all the credit for the journey you have made up to this point. I would, however, like to take this opportunity to record thanks to all our staff for their dedication and commitment to your success. But there are also other special people who've been right behind you, your family and friends, who in a million big and small ways, in quiet acts of support and generosity, and sometimes giving you a much needed push, have provided the fabric and infrastructure upon which your individual success story is built. So I think we should all take this opportunity to thank all those people who have supported the graduates on their academic journey. I know there are many, many people sitting out there in the audience who are both rightly proud and probably quite relieved that it's all over. So graduates, I want you now to please stand and give a round of applause, find them in the audience, to thank your parents, partners, families and friends, without whose support you would not have achieved what you have today. Okay, you can be seated now. Of course, an event like a graduation ceremony is in one sense hugely symbolic as a beginning and also as an end. I therefore want to leave you with the thoughts that are expressed very beautifully in a poem by an English poet, Christopher Logue, which was written in 1968. Now, this poem is entitled Come to the Edge. It is about courage, trust, and having faith in oneself and in others. It is a poem that is based on a dialogue between two voices, which perfectly mirrors the important relationship between master and pupil, between academic and student. It also, I think, beautifully describes the transformational journey our students make from their point of arrival with us as fledgling creatives to their moment of departure, which of course is today, when you literally launch yourself onto the world. So Come to the Edge by Christopher Logue, written in 1968. Come to the edge, but we might fall. Come to the edge, but it's too high. Come to the edge. And they came, and we pushed, and they flew. So graduating students, as you fly away from us today, on behalf of all my colleagues at University College Falmouth, I wish each and every one of you lots of excitement, lots of success, and lots of fun on your own creative journey. Thank you very much.
I now invite Professor Jeff Smith, Deputy Rector, to read the citation for our honorary fellow, Dr. Tom Hunter.
Professor Tom Hunter is a London-based artist working in the medium of photography, whose work is both loved locally and feted internationally. As a student experimenting with large format photography, he put some 5x4 transparencies on a light box, images of his squatted street in Hackney, and his way of looking at the world changed. He said, "Colour and light became key to the way I looked at my neighbourhood, seducing me and drawing me in to contemplation of my life, my way of living, and the culture that surrounded me." The work he produced for his degree show, The Ghetto, a photographic 3D model depicting a community squat in London Fields, was purchased by the Museum of London and is now on permanent display there. His 1998 breakthrough image was a photographic portrait of a young mother reading an eviction notice from Hackney Council that closely referenced Vermeer's 17th century painting, Girl Reading a Letter by an Open Window. Hunter's image, Woman Reading a Possession Order, won the John Coble Photographic Portrait Prize, after which interest and representation from the Saatchi and White Cube galleries soon followed. Hunter's subject matter is his neighborhood, individuals often living at life's margins, disenfranchised, disenchanted. But drawing on techniques and ideas from the golden age of Dutch painting, his work brings a dignity, a beauty, a heroism, and historical significance to the scenes and individuals he depicts. "I wanted to make them monumental," he says, "and put them in the National Gallery." This he did, becoming the first photographic artist to have a one-man show at the National Gallery, which was seen by more than 750,000 people. The exhibition there, Living in Hell and Other Stories, consisted of a series of large-scale photographs, drawing on the drama, violence, and anxieties of local news stories from Hackney, and borrowing from the mannerisms of the old masters. Hunter's approach creates interesting tensions between documentation and artifice, a key reason why the work inspires students of documentary, of photojournalism, and of a fine art approach to the photographic medium. His work is often a source of reference for the workbooks and the project research of Falmouth students. In 2009, Hunter made his first film, A Place for Us, first screened in London's Serpentine Gallery. The Guardian's review of this film, which portrays a council estate on the point of being razed to the ground, called it a magical film, a place of memory. Contemporary art seems obsessed with youth. Here it listens to the stories the old have to tell. Work from this project was later auctioned in support of the charity Shelter. Hunter continues to make an impression internationally, exhibiting everywhere from New York to Madrid, from Los Angeles to Antwerp. He's represented by high-profile galleries in London, New York, LA, and Sydney, and has work, amongst others, in the Victoria and Albert Museum, the Los Angeles County Museum of Art, and the Saatchi Collection, as well as the Museum of London and the National Gallery. So graduates, ladies and gentlemen, honored guests, I now invite Professor Anne Carlisle to confer the title of Honorary Fellow to Professor Tom Hunter.
Thank you. I suppose I need to say something now. I'm not going to say too much. They asked me to speak for 10 minutes, but I panicked this morning and thought you'd be bored stupid if I speak for that long. And it's actually going to be, it's your day, so, you know, it's all about you rather than me. So I'd really like to hear you give yourselves a really big cheer, you know, because it's you that we're all here for, yous who've done all the hard work. So give yourselves a really big cheer. Let's really hear Lift the Rafters now. Come on. Hey! Come on! Whoa! Whoa! Whew. Brilliant. Oh, that makes me feel a bit better anyway before I start. it's great to be here in Curnow today. I was told not to say Cornwall, is that right? Curnow, yep. A place which means a great deal to me. I love its coast, its culture, its megalithic monuments, the sea, which always pulls me in, both physically and spiritually, and of course its people, who are the life and soul of this great place, a place which has its own special atmosphere, far enough away from London to become its own universe, individual and proud. Yesterday, it felt like a really long journey. Could we have the lights up on the audience? It feels very strange for me to be in the spotlights when it's... Can I see you guys? Oh, thank you. That's better. I felt like this strange creature up here under the microscope, like a star's the interrogation room. So it's nice to see your faces as well. Right, I'll try and start again. Yesterday, it felt like a really long journey coming down here from London to Curno. And it is a really long way from the capital. I'm not from here, but from Dorset, where I grew up in a small village near the sea. And it did feel like I would never make that long journey to the city and to a life I wanted to make there. But here I am after taking that journey. And it was education that put me on that road. I feel incredibly proud to be made an honorary fellow of this university and to become part of what's going on here today, to celebrate with you what's going on. And to be standing here in front of you, knowing that you have taken the first steps on that road to creating careers and the lives in the subjects that you love. There is nothing better than doing what you want to do and make a living from it, which is what I've been so fortunate to achieve. It doesn't matter where this takes place, Paris, New York, Penryn, they're all equally important places. It's what you do there that matters. Now you've achieved that first step by graduating in your chosen field. Congratulations. It's time to feel proud of what you've done here. And now we look forward to seeing what comes next. You are the future. You will be taking my jobs, getting the exhibition, making the films, creating a new vision, which will knock the old time gits like me off my shelf, off my perch. So I'd like to wish you luck. But not too much luck, because I want to have a few jobs now and again. But yeah, congratulations. This is all about you and brilliant. I hope I can inspire you to do the same things that I've managed to do. It sounded like it was so easy when you talked about it today, that you just had this magical carpet ride drifting along from one thing to the other, and it's all so easy, and it was. It has been really hard, and luckily I left school when it was a recession and I didn't want a job, and I thought, great, I'll just be in the dole and do what I want to do. And having that goal of just doing what I want to do has kept me and pushed me. So unemployment, low wages, if you're doing what you want to do, it doesn't matter. And if you stick at it for long enough and you believe in it, you will make it. And please, I don't know what I was going to say then. I've had something really clever about them. Congratulations and do well and have a great time. Thank you.
Thank you, Tom. Enjoy the competition. I would now like to invite the outgoing FXU Students' Union President, Jamie Clark, to give his vote of thanks on behalf of the graduates present.
Good afternoon, ladies, gentlemen, distinguished guests, and most importantly, graduates. It's fantastic to see so many people here, despite 3 years of plentiful distractions. I'd just like to say a few words to celebrate and recognise your great achievement in being here today. I know it must seem like such a short time ago that you arrived here in Falmouth, and I know that I, for one, struggle to see where the time has gone. Yet despite this, your time at Falmouth has seen you all grow into hugely talented and inspiring young, and not so young, creative individuals. While studying, you have been supported along the way by a wide variety of people, each with their own part to play in ensuring that you had the best chance to succeed. I therefore wish to offer a vote of thanks to these people on behalf of the student body. All have supported us in one way or another over the years. Some have been very visible on a day-to-day basis, whilst others have been less so, yet all are equally essential to Falmouth's smooth operation. I would like to begin by thanking all the service support staff at both Woodlane and Tremoe, without whom literally nothing would function. Our course leaders and their teams of lecturers, technicians, who have supported us for the duration of our study. To the rector, her senior management team and their staffs for all the work they do, often behind the scenes, to ensure Falmouth's continued success for many years to come. And to the Board of Governors, who play a vital role in ensuring that Falmouth is doing all it can to improve its students' university experience. Please now join me in a round of applause. I would like to reiterate Professor Smith's thanks to those graduates who took time to become Falmouth's mentors, ambassadors, and course representatives. Without the support and dedication of these people, your voice may not have been heard or supported, and I definitely wouldn't have been able to do my job. The work done by these graduates has helped make Falmouth an exciting, friendly, and unique place to study. Last but by no means least, fellow graduates, please join me in thanking all our families and friends, many of whom are here today. I know it can be a stressful time for all, and believe me, we really do appreciate your support and the occasional beer money. When I graduated this time last year, I began to think to myself, what do I do next? In a climate where funding for the arts is being cut all the time, it can seem very daunting to attempt a career in the creative industries. However, I would like to share with you a thought which inspired me and I hope will inspire you too. Funding for the arts has always been one of the first casualties in times of hardship. However, history tells us this only serves to strengthen the resolve of those who take pleasure in them. Those that can adapt, drive change, challenge ideas and say, why not, or let's have a go, have always been those with creative and ambitious minds like yours. As you move into the unknown, please remember that you are the next generation of creative thinkers and practitioners. You remember your experiences at Falmouth and that you can make change, challenge conventions, and achieve anything you set your mind to. By being here today, you've already demonstrated that you can succeed. I would personally like to wish everyone here all the very best for the future, and I hope you can continue to succeed in whatever lies in store over the next few years. It's been my honour to represent you. Please have a wonderful day and try not to drink too much tonight. Thank you very much.
I would now like to invite Howard Jacobs, Deputy Chairman to the Board of Governors, to formally close the ceremony.
Graduates, thank you all for returning to Falmouth today to join us in celebrating these achievements. Friendships made at university are often lifelong, and I would like to encourage all graduates here today to take the opportunity to keep in touch with each other and with the University College through the Alumni Relations Office. We look forward to hearing about your achievements and successes in the future and to maintaining fruitful relationships with you. And I very much look forward to meeting some of you outside as we move to the next part of our celebrations. But first, a formal bit. Let me confirm that we have completed all the tasks pertaining to our right to grant degrees and honorary awards, and I formally close this ceremony. Please rise for the procession of the platform party and the graduates. Thank you.